I know that I will die tomorrow. If I had known in advance that I would die from cholera in Istanbul, I would still come here because it was my duty. I was dehydrated during the night. To make up for this, my doctor had given me a solution of salt and sugar. I had my breakfast and I said that there are important things I want to tell them. I want to see the soldiers who will fight for my country one last time. Henrik helped me prepare and we set out for a military unit at Galata. When we arrived at the brigade, I wasn't feeling well. I wanted to sit and rest for a while. And meanwhile, Henrik called a friend. I tried to explain to them what freedom means and why this war must be won. With the help of God, for more than 60 years, there was no country left as Poland on the map of Europe. I was proud to see the fire in their eyes of the officers and the will to do what necessary to save our country. Yes, maybe I will not be able to see those days when our country is finally independent. As I look at all the young Polish officers, my belief that this will happen soon increased. At that time, when no one else took action against neighboring enemies which crushed Poland, Turks were our only friends. We loved the Turks as a superior nation because they did not forfeit in front of our enemy and did not accept the invasion of Poland. When I finished my speech, there was silence in the room for a long time. There were tears in the eyes of some officers. We left together and arrived at the Galatasaray bed. We needed a warm Turkish bed. Beds are the hottest and most wonderful thing I have ever seen in my life. In the Turkish bath, you get rid of all your dirt by lying on the front marble called the navel stone. With the help of soap, bubbles and steam, after that by adjusting the temperature of the water from the basins, you foam and wash as you want. When you leave the bath, they will offer you a Turkish coffee and Turkish delight. This too bitter and sweet combination at the pleasure of the belt is an indescribable feeling. While my body was warm enough, I wanted to go home and sleep with that feeling. On the way home, we saw an oxen carrying hundreds of bodies that died from cholera. This disease was spreading so quickly that we didn't even know how to take action. In a million years, I wouldn't think that I would be quickly destroyed by a monster named cholera. I start to shiver when we get home. There was no trace of nice warm of the bath. Henrik also prepared tzatziki for us with the baked beans and rice. We ate this meal with great pleasure. And I wandered into my sleep, which I don't know would be my last one. Today is my last day. Waking up to the last day and being aware of it creates a terrible feeling of helplessness. Feeling deeply in pain and not having any weapons to fight against it. When I opened my eyes slightly, I saw the doctor and Henrik walking around in the small room. Oh my God, I just wanted to talk, but I couldn't. I could feel thousands of ants crawling on my hands, but I knew they weren't really there. Dr. Drozdowski was constantly telling me to drink the salt and sugar solution so that I would feel a little better. With an effort, I gathered my energy and moved to a sitting position on my bed. But this gave me the usual pain. It was unbearable. On a November day in 1855, I closed my eyes at Galata, in Ottoman lands, where I came in the name of my country, far away from Poland. Even if I knew that if I were ever encounter this result again, I will experience the same things again. I would rather die in this land than having the comfort of a professor in the academy in France. You, My young Polish friends are currently fighting an enigmatic pandemic in a free and peaceful land, which I have never had. Every darkness has a dawn and every difficulty has an end. One day all these bad days will be left behind and Poland will live forever in peace, amicably and with love. After my death, they carried my body to the church in a car pulled by two oxen. I saw people of all nations in Ottoman lands coming to the funeral ceremony. Bulgarians, French, Italians, Greeks, and Turks with whom we phoned alongside each other. In this coffin, while my eyes closed, I don't even get to breathe anymore. I left part of my body forever in Istanbul. On this cold November day, with light rain on the streets of Galatapera, went to another journey. The rudder breaks, the sails are ripped, the roar of waters mingles with the ominous sound of pumps and panic voices. All around torn rocks, the sun sets red. We hope no more. The tempests howl in triumph. From the shore, where wet cliffs rising tier on tier surround, the ocean cows dead advance, bound to carry rampants broken long before. One man has swooned, one wrings his hand, one sings upon his friends, embracing them. Some say a prayer to death, that it may pass them by. One traveler sits apart and sadly thinks, happy the man who faints or who can pray, or has a friend to whom to say goodbye. Dry beans are soaked one day before, and the next day they are lightly fired with tomato and peppers, and then boiled for 1 hour in low heat. Meanwhile, yogurt is diluted slightly and a cove of garlic is mixed with a little salt and peeled cucumbers to obtain a perfect refreshing cold dish. We ate this meal with great pleasure and I wandered into my sleep, which I didn't know would be my last one.